Zeno Education Society, redefining excellence.
Hello everyone, my name is Mukesh Shivarajpede. My group members are Ganesh Shinde, Sahil Sonar and Anmol Singh. We are from Zeel Polytechnic, 3rd year Mechanical Engineering, Division A. This activity is done under guidance of Professor Shubham Shrivas, Professor D.M. Patel and Professor S.R. Kulkarni. Let's begin.
So, our topic is solar-based advanced water quality monitoring system using wireless sensor network. Contents: introduction, system structure, hardware structure, layout of system, and conclusion. Introduction. In 21st century, there were lots of inventions, developments, and globalization. But in that time, there were pollutions, global warming are also be formed. Because of this, there is no safe drinking water for world's population. To take preventive actions for quality maintenance, we got an idea that a system should be implemented to monitor the quality of water in easy way. So, it can be easily analyzed some of the critical and important factors of water. System structure. Measurement of pH, oxygen level and turbidity of water using sensors at remote place. To avail local power supply to sensor nodes using solar energy. To collect data from various sensor nodes and send it to base station by wireless channel. To control data communication between source and sink nodes. To simulate and analyze quality parameters for quality control. To publish the corresponding record over web for public information and further assessment of water resource. In hardware structure, there are four components. First is pH sensor interfacing, second is oxygen sensor interfacing, third is turbidity sensor interfacing, and fourth is solar panel interfacing. Now let's see pH sensor interfacing. This sensor is used to measure the pH level of water. The high accuracy pH probe IH20 is used as a pH sensor, which has output voltage from negative 412 millivolt to positive 412 millivolt. The theoretical output of the IH20 pH probe is approximately. For acid, output voltage is positive, for neutral it is null, and for base it becomes negative with 59 millivolt per unit pH starting from null. This is the circuit diagram for pH sensor interfacing. Now next is oxygen sensor interfacing. This sensor is used to measure the density of oxygen in water. The main difficulty of measuring voltage across these probes is that the output impedance of the probe is very high. So a high input impedance component is chosen to match it. Next is turbidity sensor interfacing. In this system, turbidity sensor is to measure the clarity of water. The output voltage range represents turbidity value. Next is solar panel interfacing. In a practical water quality monitoring system where sensor nodes are distributed in remote sites, power supply has become an extremely important issue. To avoid unnecessary work and make the system more flexible to deploy, solar panel is used in this system to supply power for the sensor node. Together with the battery to recharge when solar power is not enough, such as night. This is the circuit diagram for solar panel interfacing. Now let's see the actual layout of system. In this diagram, we can see remote monitoring station, wireless sensor network, local monitoring station, and different nodes placed at different places. Conclusion. This system not only provides comprehensive evaluation of water environment, but also can quickly discover urgent water pollution accident or natural disasters. Transferring the abnormal water quality information to monitoring center by quicker communication network. Thank you.